right time. They're only available for the day in which they're presented, only until the end of that day, and only while supplies last. Here's the other thing to remember. It's the lowest price you'll see on the item for an entire year. So this is something very special. You know and love Mama Mancini's meatballs. So we went into the recipe archives of Mama Mancini, and we went after her meatloaf recipes. Yes. But we didn't want to bring you great big meatloaves. We wanted to bring you a sampling of different kinds of meatloaves in a size that would be more portion friendly. Well, Daniel Mancini is back with us. He's the grandson of Mama Mancini, and we're thrilled to have you here, sir.
It's great to be
with
here.
With a one-time only value and your grandma's meatloaf. What do you remember most about grandma's meatloaf, thinking back when you were a kid?
Well, it was homemade. The kitchen, the aroma when she put this together was just unbelievable. And it was something we always look forward to.
And
it was
you.
Our comfort food. That's myself and my grandmother. Yeah.
And this is the only picture, I believe you told me, that exists of the two of you alone.
Yeah, it's the only. We didn't have digital back then.
Oh, so, it's so great.
Yeah, so it was one photo.
So these are cupcake sized.
Yes.
But don't
let
the word cupcake mislead you. This is not a sweet food. This is regular, delicious, homemade meatloaf, but in the size of a cupcake.
Look at this.
Now, Daniel, you're getting 12 of these. Each one is 6 ounces in size.
Yes.
And there are three flavors. So we have either the traditional,
which is going
to be your regular and delicious meatloaf. We also have the Parmesan.
Yes.
Most limited, and we have the Gorgonzola. But let's come back over to Dan's cutting board and start with the original, because, Dan, this is truly traditional meatloaf.
This is the exact way my grandmother would make her meatloaf, and just like our meatballs that we bring to QVC, we use real ingredients, the same ingredients my grandmother would use.
Mm.
You can identify them all. You know them all. They're all the ingredients that you're so used to using. So the original, all beef, and then we just put some tomato topping on it. That was my grandmother's traditional tomato topping. Then this one, David, is our Gorgonzola spinach.
Okay, before we get there, I'm going to have to taste the original.
Of course.
All right, so let me get a fork and get in here.
Here we go.
Let me have a little, I want to get a little bit of the glaze on top.
There you are.
Let me just go right here. Help me with a knife right there. Perfect. Beautiful.
So you're tasting all these authentic real ingredients.
Mm. Okay, first, super moist.
Yes.
We've all had meatloaf that was bland. This is anything but bland. Look at the gorgeous ingredients. Real cheeses, beautiful mustard. There's a little mayo in there, fresh garlic. There are marvelous flavors in here, and that is,
damn, isn't that incredible?
Amazing.
Thank you. Thank you. We know when you start with grandma's recipe, you know, it's kind of foolproof, right? Mm. And we follow it exactly. And by the way, each one of these, just like our meatballs, made by hand. Every one of these are made by hand.
And they're not tough. You know, you overwork meatloaf and it ends up being tough like shoe leather.
Yes.
This is delightful. Now let's talk Gorgonzola.
Yeah. So this is Gorgonzola. So we start with grandma's original, just like this. We fill each cupcake form. Hand fill them,
right.
And then we make an indentation, and then we fill it with Gorgonzola cheese, spinach, and bacon.
What?
Exactly. And you know, when I was making this, I'm saying, this is for David.
Bacon.
So you add bacon. And you're getting, again, you're getting 12 of these individually wrapped, so you use what you want to use,
and this
the
is
rest will stay in the freezer.
This is the Gorgonzola.
That's the Gorgonzola, spinach, and bacon.
Oh my gosh. Every single meatloaf is so flavorful. If you've always complained that meatloaf was bland, say goodbye to bland meatloaf.
Right.
This is outstanding. Now, I'm really excited to taste this Parmesan.
Well, the Parmesan is incredible.
Now, it's a beef meatloaf, but it's got a Parmesan topping. Is that right?
Yes, so it's made similar to this. We start with the meatloaf. We hand fill each cupcake form, and then we make an indentation, and inside, we put our Parmesan topping, and we put the topping on top as well. And that is two cheeses. You've got your Romano, you got your Asiago, and our tomato, as well as some Italian seasonings that we use.
Okay.
And you're getting 12 of those as well.
Okay. All three are happy dance worthy. Get it. Get it. Big first Sunday happy dance of the new year.
Thank you.
This is crazy. 700 of these are gone. Lowest price you're going to see for a year. You can lock this in with auto delivery. And here's the good news. We're going to deliver these every 90 days for a year. And Daniel, if you decide after the first shipment, let's say you try the traditional.
Yes.
And then for the second shipment, you want to switch to Parmesan. Let us know before we ship and we'll switch out the flavor.
Perfect.
And you can also get the Gorgonzola. This is one-time only value priced. and it's three easy payments of $22.98. I'm telling you, if you love not just run-of-the-mill meatloaf, I'm talking great meatloaf, outstanding meatloaf, old world meatloaf.
Grandma's
made. That's what this is about. 1,000 sets are gone.
Look at
this. If you want the traditional, okay, take a look right, and we'll shoot right over here. If you want the traditional, and that's our most popular, I have 1,700 left in the traditional. This Parmesan is some of the best I've ever put in my mouth.
Thank you.
1,200 left in the Parmesan. Gorgonzola, 1,300 all I have left to go around. Remember, this is the lowest price you're going to see on this item for a year. Think about entertaining. Think about the
wonderful
big game.
Perfect for the
Think
big game.
Think about that. These are all shipping immediately. So if you wanted to make these up, and we're going to talk about cooking methods in just a moment.
Okay.
But if you wanted to cook these up for the big game, you could slice them into quarters and toothpick them. If you wanted to make a little extra ketchup dipping sauce for that
perfect.
Original.
Delicious.
If you wanted to get a little marinara sauce for the dipping for the Parmesan,
sure.
You could. And if you wanted to sprinkle a little extra gorgonzola on that other, no one's feelings are hurt there.
Yeah.
This is so easy and so delicious, and the portions are awesome. Let's talk about these. They arrive frozen.
Yes.
I'm so excited about these. They're so good. How best do we cook these?
The best thing to do is you decide how many you would like to use. You cut them out of the pack because they're all frozen.
So you only take out what you need.
Only take out what you need. The rest are going to stay frozen up to a year.
And we should let these thaw.
Let them thaw.
What, overnight in the fridge?
Overnight in the fridge is perfect, David.
Okay.
You take the cup that they come in, the little cupcake cup, put it on a baking dish into a 350 degree oven, 30 minutes. They're done.
So let them thaw.
Yes.
Take them in this cup, put them on a baking dish, put them in a 350 oven for, did you say?
Like 30 minutes, 30 minutes.
Gives you enough time to make some mashed potatoes and a green vegetable, and you have a meal.
Yes.
These are outstanding.
Thank
How many
you.
Are gone now, Sean? Over 1,800 of these are gone. We're very busy on our phone lines. Anita is joining us in Florida. Anita, are you ready for meatloaves in the size of a cupcake?
I sure am.
Ooh, you're going to love these. Now, have you ever tried Mama Mancini's meatballs?
Yes, I have.
Oh.
You have tried them.
Thank
Wonderful.
You.
Well, then you already know the commitment to quality and fresh ingredients. Can you imagine that same great care now with your favorite meatloaf flavor?
Can't wait to get them. We've got Mama Mancini's. When they first came out, we got the first packaging. And then when we got the smaller ones, we got that. And now we're
nice.
Ready for the meatloaf.
Oh,
well,
thank you, Anita.
I know you're going to love it. Which flavor of the meatloaf did you go with?
We went with the traditional today.
You are not going to be disappointed. I'll tell you, Anita, this is some of the finest meatloaf I've ever had. And you know what I was thinking, Anita? You could cook up several of these, slice them into little patties, and make meatloaf slider sandwiches.
Right over here. We actually have them right here to see. We
you could
them.
Do that. You could make sandwiches.
Yes.
You could make, you could toothpick these and, you know, slice them and toothpick them for parties. You could have a couple for your lunch. They're just ideal.
Yeah, we already do that with the meatballs, too. We really enjoy them just almost any old way at all.
Oh, my word. Well, I'm so glad you're trying these. Be sure and let us know what you think, and we'll get that traditional out to you right away, okay?
Thank you very much.
Thank
Thanks
you,
for
Anita.
To me.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
Thank
You're
you,
welcome.
Daniel.
You're welcome
Thank
anytime.
You.
Come back
Thank
and visit
you.
Us.
Oh, that's so sweet.
2,500 are
now
gone. If you want traditional, I have 1,000 left in traditional. If you want Parmesan, 700 left. These Parmesan are kicking.
Isn't that incredible?
And Gorgonzola, 1,000 left to go around. They're amazing too. They're stuffed with gorgonzola cheese, bacon, sauteed spinach, garlic, all the things that you love. These quality ingredients that you see on this plate. We'll just let you know that the same great care and quality ingredients that go into the meatballs are going into these meatloaves. And the meatloaves are individually portioned. So we call them meatloaf cupcakes because they're the size of a cupcake.
Yes, yes. We decided to make individual portions. And these are great. You know, you come home from work at night, David. You don't want to start and prepare an entire meal. You want something quickly.
I think we're going to swap out some fresh cutters. So we're going to bring in some new ones. So we'll just step back here a moment, let our crew come in and bring us some fresh out of the oven. And we'll show you some more goodies here. That's okay. Over half of our quantity is now gone. Mark Charles, I see you waiting in the wings. You want some meatloaf, don't you? You should try the Parmesan first. It's delightful. Okay.
Here we go.
All right. They're all delicious, and I don't mean to show a favoritism because you know me, I love all food. I don't discriminate. I love all the food, except for Brussels sprouts. I don't understand them. all right. So this is M50133. Over half of our quantity is gone. Think about this. It's the new year. We're trying to be better about portions.
Yes.
But we don't want to give up the things we love. Now, I could get behind eating smaller portions if I still get to eat my regular recipe. So why not enjoy a cupcake-sized meatloaf or two?
Sure.
Four. When you need a meal, when you need a quick sandwich, look at that gorgonzola cheese.
Is that incredible?
And it's beautiful and creamy, and the sautéed spinach and the garlic and the bacon. God's most perfect food. So this is M50133. Very, very busy on our phone lines. Let's go through our three flavors, and let me tell you what I have left, beginning with traditional, and that's been the most popular. 700 left in the traditional. In the Parmesan, 400 all I have left in the Parmesan. Gorgonzola, 900 remaining. And let's come over here and cut into that original again very slowly. Hang on one sec. We're going to get a nice camera shot. Because I want everyone to see at home, you thaw these out the night before in your refrigerator. Take them out. Keep them in their cupcake. Look how moist that is.
Is that incredible?
Just press right there just a little bit, Daniel. I want everyone to see. Look how you doing. Come on. I have, when I was a little boy, sometimes we go over to a neighbor's house. I'd be invited, a neighbor kid would, moms would invite me over for dinner, and they'd make meatloaf. And I'd come home and mom would say, well, how was dinner, sweetie? I was like, Mrs. Johnson made meatloaf. And she goes, how was it? And I said, dry. Even as a child, I was a foodie. I was. And I didn't like dry meatloaf. And so, you know, we've all been there. Sometimes we've made meatloaf and it's turned out dry as an old piece of shoe leather. And you're thinking, oh, no, no. Let Mama Mancini's do all the heavy lifting. These are moist, melt in your mouth, and they're delightful. A one-time only value means they're only good at this price until end of day today and only while the supply lasts. But let me update you on what remains. We started with over 5,300 sets. If you want traditional, there's 500 left in traditional. If you want Parmesan, 200 left in the Parmesan. Now remember, these are beef meatloaves. It's not chicken. It's beef, but with a Parmesan, like a tomato sauce and
Asiago, Romano, and our tomato sauce, and just a little spice.
So a little Parmesan topping.
Yep.
And Gorgonzola, 800 remain. We're very, very busy on the phone lines. Time for one more bite here, sir.
Which one would you like to try, David?
It never hurts my feelings, any of them. Let's see. Let's try the traditional. Give me a little cut there. Perfect. Mm.
Mm-hmm. And the hand forming keeps these moist, and that's the secret to making a homemade moist meatloaf.
You know what? It makes my hand shoulders relax. It just
that's
makes
it.
Me feel like I'm home again, having comfort food. And you know what? This unusual warm snap we've had in early winter, I think, is about to give way to much colder weather. They're saying middle of the week, we might have snow flurries here in Pennsylvania.
It's coming.
I said flurries, not a storm. Don't get crazy. Okay, what's sold out? Oh, the Parmesan is sold out. Here.
Oh, okay.
Here you go, Kevin. Try not to eat them all in one place.
We're all waiting in the wings there to try these.
These meatloaves are so good. We still have Gorgonzola and we have the original, but 300 traditional. 700 Gorgonzola, and these are all flying. Will you do us one favor?
Absolutely.
Will you make more of these?
I would love to.
And let's get our heads together. I would love to maybe work with you on some flavors on these forward.
Be my honor. That'd
these
be terrific.
Are fantastic. I think we can really grow this whole idea and do some other flavor
terrific.
Ideas. Oh, make one with mac and cheese.
Mac and cheese. Oh, that'd be incredible.
There you go. All right. So we'll talk more about that. But these, get them while you can. Big home run, Daniel.
Thank you, David.
Really
awesome.
Thank
you, everyone.
These are dynamite, you guys. Let's check in with our Mary. Hey, Mary, maybe we can make you a gluten-free meatloaf.
Oh, that'd be so awesome. You know what makes good? Instead of breadcrumbs, use the potato flakes, you know, the instant potato flakes. Delicious, and they act just like breadcrumbs when you're making meat.